November 6th. Canelo or Plant?
Canelo.
How?
What you mean, how?
How he gonna get it done, yeah.
If he knocked him out, it's gonna be in the last three rounds.
You think so?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I actually want Caleb Plant to win, but Canelo.
Same situation with Deontay Tyson.
Yeah.
Same thing, kind of. I kind of want Caleb Plant. He be DMing me and stuff like that. I never spoke to Canelo, but putting all that shit aside, like, I think Canelo gonna win, but I think Caleb Plant's gonna pull up a hell of a fight, too.
Yeah.
I think he'll pull up a hell of a fight. Like,
it's gonna be one of
them. It might be, like, willing to rematch type shit. Like, yeah. I think Caleb Plant's gonna be like, I think Caleb Plant probably got more skills than Billy Joe.
Listen, it's a champ against champs. You have to respect both of them.
Definitely.
But Canelo to me is the favorite. I'm not hating on anybody. I have no beef with nobody. I'm just saying he's the pound for pound king, and he's seen every style. He's 52-1 with 38 knockouts.
Yeah.
Caleb Plant is 21-0 with 13 knockouts, 12 knockouts. So favoring Canelo, but we'll see what happens. It's a huge fight. And another fight that's coming up: Shakur and Jermell Herring.
That's a cool knockout.
Jermell's in the way here.
Shakur by stoppage, like last four rounds, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, you know how
it goes. Yeah, I got Shakur by knockout.
For real?
Yes.
See, they was in his training camp, so talk to them about that. They was in his training camp.
The way he been sparring,
the way he been looking, the way he been training.
He been sparring Shakur.
Yeah, the way he been looking.
So now for this fight?
Yeah.
I can see that. You're tall, you're like, you're probably, yeah.
Talk to him.
Yeah, so I feel like Shakur.
You even have a beard like Jermell.
Say that again.
The goatee, but go on, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I mean, he's been looking great in camp. He's been going hard. He know the stakes of this fight. And then I know Shakur, like, when it's a personal fight or it's a big fight, it's a real big fight.
He steps up.
He steps it up.
Yeah, he there.
Yeah, he locks in.
So it's like 100%. I say TKO. I ain't gonna say like, he probably break him down and stop him.
Now, I can see that. I can see if y'all say a knockout.
Yeah, TKO.
I can see like a TKO, but I don't see Shakur like, boom, and knock him out. I don't see that.
Yeah, TKO, yeah. I say like round 9-10.
Okay.
9-10.
Javonta Davis against Rolies. Why that face? Rolly has a chance. 13-0.
He fight Rolly.
13-0, 12 knockouts. He could crack. He has power.
But he got no skills. He got nothing. That stuff he be throwing, no.
I feel like,
no hate me.
When it comes to that fight,
it's just the truth.
Yeah.
Only chance that Rolly has is getting a lucky hard shot off. Other than that, Tank probably wiped the boys on him.
Shit, let's be real. Tank done got hit before? That nigga still knock you out.
Yeah, that's true. So I'm saying, like,
Tank what is he gonna do?
But I will say this, out of Tank's 25 opponents, Rolly will be the first one that talks smack.
Yeah.
Because Leo's a good kid, he doesn't talk.
Yeah,
and not only that, but you had Barrios doesn't talk.
Yeah, I'm a good kid.
Gambardes, they're all, and all of his opponents, like, so this is the point that.
Barrios to stop Rudy.
You think so?
Yes.
Yeah, what?
I think Barrios.
I don't even know how he got the fight.
I think, yeah.
Okay.
It was a close ass fight with him and Tank until Tank started putting it on, like, the later rounds. But leading up to that, it was close.
I thought Tank was in command from the get go, bro.
That shit won't like Tank win it. No, it was not. It was like Tank
yeah,
got it.
Down, like,
yeah, he like Tank got it. You know.
But I still feel like he was in control.
Definitely,
he was in control.
Okay, yeah. Ryan Garcia and JoJo.
That's a good fight. I got Ryan though, like, yeah. off his range and his speed, you know?
Yeah,
and JoJo fight.
Short. Gonna let his hand.
JoJo too.
And JoJo has, JoJo fight, I feel like it's perfect for Ryan, honestly, my bad. I think it's perfect for Ryan how JoJo fight, so. But it's gonna be a hell of a fight though.
Decision, knockout, what do you guys say?
Probably clip JoJo. He probably could get him out of there, but
okay.
He probably dropped him. I feel like JoJo would get up.
Let me ask you guys this. Yeah. What do you want to see? Who do you want to see Devin Haney fight next? I mean, obviously, Teofimo has his fight with Kambosis. Loma's fighting Kome. So.
When I walk through.
Loma? Who's Loma fighting?
Loma's fighting Kome. Richard Kome?
Richard, yes.
Who already fought.
Why is he fighting Richard Kome?
Because he's available. Because he wants to show that he could do
a Devin fight. I don't even know.
Yeah.
But say him and Loma, let's say they fight. Who wins that one?
Kobe?
No, Loma and... No, Loma's going to be Kobe, but yeah. Loma and Devin.
Yeah, that's a...
Who wins?
I don't even think that's a good one. I think Devin would beat the hell out of Loma.
Too little.
Yeah.
Too little.
I don't know.
I think Devin would beat the hell out of
Loma. Loma nice.
Because you got to realize, cuz, when Lomachenko start like pushing over Teofimo, Teofimo don't got no good legs, so he couldn't get away for real. That nigga Devin, he going to be all... He can do it all. You feel me? So
okay.
What Loma going to do? And we see that Devin can fight for 12 rounds against his last fight. He got hurt and everything.
Yeah. What do you guys think about this?
He's going to do it better for the second time.
Terrence Crawford and Sean Porter. You just saw Terrence train for about an hour and a half. Keep the same pace from the first second to the last second.
I think
6 weeks out.
He's ready to fight tonight. That's impressive.
Terrence good at punching in between punches.
That's a fact.
So I feel like he could catch him clean and maybe get him
exactly how Earl Spence knocked him down.
But Sean Porter, he an aggressive fighter.
He has experience. He's been there.
And he gonna Terrence Crawford gonna have to stay on his A game basically.
And that's
Sean in amateurs was 164, so he's coming down. And and Crawford started at 35, 40, 47. I mean, undisputed.
Yeah. I just feel like Terrence, like boxing abilities, is gonna be too much for Sean Porter.
Yeah.
And if you do catch him in between them shots, I feel like he probably do clip Sean Porter.
But by the way, I don't know if you guys know who Frank Stea is.
Frank Stea, yes sir.
What can you tell me about him?
Man, he's a hell of a dude, man. I've been knowing him for a little while.
Come here, Frank, come here. I've known him forever. I've known him when I just started covering boxing.
For real?
Yeah. And you know what he is now? He's the head of the Camp Fury.
I see him, Gypsy Kid.
And he made a special stool for Fury. Who would you want a special stool for? Like a stool?
With stool?
Nah.
It has a
face on it.
For the fight.
Parker face, that's it?
Yeah, we'll get it. Wait, is here? Let me see it.
I'll show you that shit.
Okay. So who would be the one guy you want to fight the most? Who's number one on your hit list?
That I want to fight?
Yeah, right now from the pros.
Honestly, Elie, I don't have nobody for real.
No beefing with nobody?
I don't mean looking at people like, I would love to fight that person. It don't really matter, honestly.
Anybody can get it.
Yeah, for real.
You're the can man. Have you met the can man?
Well, no, I saw you on a Zone show. You called out, what's his name?
Hey, the champ is here. Can I introduce you to the guys? That's Frank. KEYSHAWN Davis, fresh off the Olympics with the medal. Kelvin Davis. Kelvin, stand up for a second. Stand up. Stand up for a second. I wanted to show something funny.
I'm a fan of him.
Wait, really quick. No, okay, we won't do it. Everybody loves you. So, is there anyone you want to fight in the pros? Anyone you want to?
Anyone I want to fight in pro, I mean, I fight anybody, really. I ain't really trying to duck nobody. I ain't into all that. You know, these fighters nowadays, they trying to pick the easy way out, like ducking all the time.
Well, it's a business, too. You got to be smart. You can't go in for the toughest fight.
Of course.
Because you're a name, your brother's a name, they're going to try to, like, beat you for that. But
yeah, I learned that. But I'm saying, once you get to that top spot, I'm saying.
You want to fight everybody.
Fight anybody, yeah.
You agree?
I agree with Calvin.
Yeah, is there anybody you want to fight right now in the pros?
Tell them about your trip.
I ain't turning pro no time soon. I'm trying to go to the Olympics.
France 2024 and then LA 2028, right?
Yeah.
Paris,
not LA.
2024.
Yeah, not LA. Yeah, nah, well, I ain't going to 2028. 2024 though, for sure.
Even if you win the gold?
3 more years.
Yeah, I'm going to win the gold in 2024 and turn pro.
That's it? By the way, you guys heard about Aiba in the 2016 games?
Yeah.
11 fights were predetermined the day before.
It's crazy.
Yeah. Sucks for the fighters that you train up.
Yeah, it
is what it is.
It's the best part about that is us fighters already knew. They just confirmed it.
It's always politics.
They just confirmed it.
Teofimo's dad was at Olympics and he told me right when he came back home, like, Aiba's corrupt. They robbed us. He fought some French dude, won every round and lost.
Yeah, I watched it. It was a hell of a fight. Think about it like this though. Why the hell World Championships is going on this month, at the end of this month. Why the hell World Championships, Aiba Boxing is giving out $100,000 in the Olympics? They ain't give a shit.
No, sign me up.
Why are they doing like this bad?
Well, here's the crazy part that's kind of sad. In the U.S., you won a medal. Can I tell people how much you got?
Yeah.
25, right?
Yeah.
In other countries, you win a medal, you get 10 million, 5 million, a million, a house, and a car.
Wow.
The guys from Uzbekistan, when they win a medal... You didn't know that?
My niggas get cribs and what?
Yeah, did you know that, Frank?
I think he's gonna fight for Uzbekistan at 2024.
No, he says you're gonna fight. No. They get millions of dollars, apartments, and cars.
You said
there's a dude from the Ukrainian team who won a medal with same 2012. He trains in LA, 18-0, 10 knockouts. And he told me after he comes home, gets a brand new car, gets an apartment, and gets money. But the U.S. should do that, but they don't.
Fight for another country.
Yeah, U.S. they don't give you anything. That's cool.
It was that last chump change. Yeah.
What are you gonna buy? An 87 Corolla?
You feel me? Don't care about this, man. That's not even a damn car. They
at the same time, the opportunities they have overseas is not like what we have over here either in the pro game. So
that's well.
That's a big no. It don't. That's a big difference from because you still can have your debut and get knocked the fuck out.
That's true.
And you don't come back the next fight.
There's not guarantee.
After amateur, you already set. After the Olympics, you already set. Yeah. Instead of still working for it.
It's different.
That's why a lot of people go just go pro.
Yeah, exactly. So, tell the fans where to follow you.
Follow us, man. Follow us, DB3. DB3 Enterprises on Instagram.
Yes, sir.
Get y'all.
Where they follow you at, Frank?
What's that?
American Love Machine. Why you the American Love Machine, Frank?
Inside thing.
It sounds like a fan only fans page.
It is. My
page. That's what it sounds like.
Follow me, Kelvin Davis, 2 underscores on the gram. Kelvin Davis, 1 underscore on Twitter.
There you have it. Stay tuned.
KEON Davis, but KEON Survived Davis backwards on Instagram.
I got they need American Love Machine with all them underscores and backspaces.
Yeah, that's an easier name. So there you have it. Look out for them big things coming in boxing this year and in 2024. EsNewsReport.com. I'm going to sit back reporting.